Hi. I believe in open. Even more, I believe in companies who support open. I believe in OpenStack. I've been part of the OpenStack journey for 6 years, so I saw the hype. But what I see now at the moment with OpenStack is a fact of maturity. OpenStack is now the perfect platform to host new technologies, software on top of it. Like I heard before, open infrastructure. But what I also see is that OpenStack is ready, and our friends from the Open Telecom Cloud spoke about it, was the fact to host new hardware, GPUs, FPGAs, and more. So that's the nice thing is, you see OpenStack growing, and one of the things is it's now ready to help, for example, carriers, telecoms, but also enterprises to go further with things. So what you see now is the upcoming things of the Internet of Things. It's not only OpenStack in the data center anymore. It's now about connecting things. Because at this age, sometimes we talk about the digital transformation. The digital transformation for me is when we start connecting non-servers to each other, especially with the coming of 5G in the telecom world. You will see that we need more and more things getting together. So that cloud that we have, based on OpenStack, has to be better, has to grow. Yes. So at Huawei, we created what we call the full stack. And the full stack cloud is something that not only is a convergence of infrastructure, but also combined with data, combined with services on top of it. And then we can get the cloud which is ready to do more than just virtualization. At Huawei, our full stack cloud, ready to host carriers, has five key technologies built in. And it's called, one of them is AI, artificial intelligence. We're talking about it, but we also have to do it. Big data, the cloud itself, DevOps, part of the world now, and edge computing. I think those things will make sure that clouds are ready for the future. And now I'm going in some details about this. Artificial intelligence. Why artificial intelligence? For me, it's very clear. I saw when we go from virtualization to cloud, the nice thing is features in the cloud. But the most important thing is, and what I also heard from our friends, is the day two, operations. When you want to run operations, there are incidents. There are failures. There are faults. But the most important thing is how to fix faults, how to reduce downtime, how to make sure that we deliver clouds which are, for my part, when I look at it, with 7 nines of uptime. So at that moment, we have to use artificial intelligence to make sure that we can create what I would call self-healing clouds. For example, on the networking part, we got an incident in that site, we got an incident in that site, let's make sure that the cloud itself can heal and fix that situation. Big data. If you want to do artificial intelligence, AI is based on data. So we want to make sure that we also integrate in our clouds data solutions, traditional databases, Hadoops, but also the massive parallels. And then, at that moment, now it's easy to get data inside that cloud. The biggest problem is, how can you release it? How you can unleash it? And one of the things that, indeed, OpenStack is capable of is open that situation to make it reliable and secure for everybody. Part of the cloud is the cloud itself. One of the things that we have, and one of the advantages of Huawei has at the moment, is the fact is we have public clouds. We also have partners with public clouds. When we use that information, when we use that experience that we have, and we concentrate that, our mission is to deliver private clouds with a public cloud feeling. So we want to make sure that we have clouds for NFVI, IT clouds, B2B clouds, even gaming clouds for my part, but make sure that we deliver it as a, what I would say, as a public cloud experience. Because too many IT is outsourced to public clouds because, for example, of the latency of the latency in their own IT infrastructure. DevOps. It's part of it, you know? Life cycles of software of six months is so 2000. I want to deliver DevOps, containers, all those new tools that developers can create the new applications, the cloud-native ones, the ones who run in the cloud and are made for the cloud. So we really have to make sure that we also have work, OpenStack works with the Kubernetes and with other tools on top in the right way and delivered ready for production. And the nice thing is also, when sometimes I hear the discussion with my customers or my friends, what is better, Kubernetes, OpenStack, or whatever? For me, there's no war between technologies. It's team play, really. Edge computing. And for me, edge is more than just a server somewhere in a basement somewhere getting things. I think the most important thing about edge computing is because we're going to have that Internet of Things, they're going to produce massive, massive billion things of data. But before we can host that in our central warehouse, we have to make sure that the data is processed where it's created. Maybe, like I said, when we have cars, the data of the car will be processed in the car. When we have cows, the data of the cow will be produced at the cow. We have an Internet of Cows already. And also, we want to make sure that when we have that edge and that sends that data, that it's also done in a manageable way, you know? You want to make sure that it's manageable. And that's also one of the things that I like now to see with OpenStack is that they also, developers are developing edge solutions which integrate with OpenStack. So, I talk about many things, but one of the most important things is, of course, can we deliver this? I'm responsible in Western Europe for the Fusion Cloud, or full-stack cloud solution from Huawei. But what I also want to say is, at the moment, there are 31 large telecom providers using our clouds in production. The most important thing is, one of the things is, this is an Italian customer just from last month, is that we delivered a production-ready cloud which is not just OpenStack, and it has a basis of OpenStack, and as you know, I love OpenStack, but the fact is, it has much more technologies. We integrate with an Amazon, with an Azure, with tools on top of it, like I said, Hadoop, VMware even integration, because that carrier wants to deliver one platform, easy to manage, to his business customers, but with many technologies combined to one. Now, I think that's very important that we see is that there's no war between the clouds. It's working together. Also, what I think is very important is that when I build clouds with some customers, is that we do it in a partnership, you know? I'm not going to just throw a cloud over to a customer, or I'm just going to throw a product over there. I want to make sure that we can deliver value from beginning, from day one. That means also working together as partners to deliver and to understand what we want to deliver at the end customers in a way. And to be honest, since I work for Huawei, I'm so proud to say that Huawei, in the last years, really became one of the leaders in open source. We are committed to open source, we are committed to OpenStack, and we want to be a leader. And yesterday I had a talk with some of my development colleagues, and it's nice to see that also those guys really want to learn, want to see the open source community grow, and not OpenStack, but also other communities, you know? We love many open source things. So that's, yeah. I love open source, I believe in open source, I believe in open. The only thing I can say is, if you have questions, we got a booth over there. Tomorrow, there's a dedicated forum for carriers organized by Huawei. For the rest, my friends, colleagues, enjoy the summit, and I would say thank you very much for being here. Bye. Have a great day.